Now, without further ado, it's my pleasure to introduce the president of the National Academy of Medicine, Dr. Victor Dzau, who will offer some opening remarks.
Thank you, Ashley, and welcome, everyone. I'm really pleased to have the opportunity this afternoon to take a few moments to discuss the importance of bringing lessons from humanities and arts to bear on our ongoing public health crisis. You know, a crisis as complex and multifaceted as the global pandemic will certainly require more than just science and medicine to address. The arts and humanities have an important role to play as partners with science and medicine in building public trust in the interventions we develop to combat the disease. Some of you may be well aware that in 2018, the National Academies released a report called Branches from the Same Tree that examined the impact of educational experience that intentionally integrate humanities and arts with science, technology, engineering, mathematics, and medicine on the undergraduate and graduate students. Now, the National Academies pursued the study to offer a great understanding of the groundswell of programs and courses across the United States that are seeking to break down the disciplinary silos through innovative education approaches. Among the benefits of such an integrated approach to education is the ability for students to appreciate how the various disciplines of arts, humanities, and science can work together to address complex real-world problems, which are sometimes described as weak problems. Well, unfortunately, we face just such a problem today. Currently, with the coronavirus unrelenting spread, scientists and physicians around the globe are rushing to create a safe and effective COVID-19 vaccine. But the global race underway is to roll out a successful vaccine that would ultimately hinge on the public's perception of vaccine safety and efficacy. Already, we've seen the consequence of public skepticism of measures to control the pandemic itself, with many individuals questioning the efficacy or necessity of public health measures such as mask, social distancing, or even the other measures. So the vaccine hesitancy, of course, is a very important issue we're talking about today, because this is well documented among numerous population groups in the U.S., with reasons given concerns such as side effects, effectiveness, religious concern, mistrust of government, and regulatory decisions being made. Well, we're dealing with COVID-19, no exception. The vaccine will be useless if widespread mistrust lead to the unwillingness of people to receive it. Many of you know, surveys already found that as few as 50% of people in the United States are committed to receiving a vaccine, with 25 to 30 saying they would not take the vaccine when it's available. So without a significant portion of population receiving vaccine, herd immunity will not be achieved, won't be able to stop the transmission of virus. This is why it's so important to address the issue of trust right now. Now, the challenge is compounded by the fact that the hype around the effective vaccine, the warp speed, is getting people nervous about, is it really done with great care? But on top of that, when the vaccine is available, the initial supply will be limited. So policymakers must develop plans to ensure equitable allocation of limited doses until there's sufficient supply. Thank you, Francis, who's on this conference. A request from him, a call from him in early July says, can you do it quickly? Along with CDC, asked the National Academies to form a committee on equitable allocation vaccine for this coronavirus, and to create a framework to determine who's going to get it first, second, and third if the doses are limited in the beginning. Well, we all know this effort has to be transparent, science-based, objective, equitable, and it must be trusted by the public. So we have done what we believe as much as we can. We need to do a lot more by first making discussion draft of the framework to the public comment. Receive over 1,000 public comments, We had a listening session where there are more than 50 people who spoke. And we have further revised our document according to the comments. But I think we need to do a lot more to gain trust. We have to hold community meetings, large and small. And of course, we're recommending to the US government to launch a national campaign similar to the 1950 polio vaccine campaign and the 1988 eradication of polio vaccine campaign, where the public would know the nature of the vaccine, the efficacy, safety, and to get them comfortable and trust what's coming down the pike. So our hope today is that the contribution of arts, humanity, and science will together help us inform the public's perception of vaccine safety and the importance of creating and sustaining public trust regarding its use. So we're so pleased to partner with the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. And of course, I'm a proud member of that academy. We're delighted to present today's speakers as they share their perspectives on fostering truth and honesty in these uncertain times. So thank you very much.